Shall now go on to our next speaker, Dr. Siddharth, who's a senior consultant in cornea, cataract, and refractive surgery from the Shankara Group of Eye Hospitals, another extremely skilled surgeon with a brilliant career ahead. He's going to be talking to us on surgical pearls for graft failure. And Dr. J.K. Reddy, I would want you to take a question for him. On to you, Dr. Siddharth.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Chitra and the ARC team for inviting me for this PG update. My topic is a very different topic here because I have talked and I've heard a lot about graft preparation and the unfolding techniques, but this portion of graft delivery is a very small portion, meaning that after you prepare the graft and until you try to unfold. So I would like to discuss with these three components. My talk is going to be around this. So as Dr. Rajesh Fogler very clearly showed different techniques how to remove. The most important part is, like, as he showed, there may be peripheral tags, there may be irregular removal in the periphery, and then when you punch, it can readily come inside the center and tear the entire tissue, or it can have a wrinkling into the center of the DM. The second part is how you transfer into the injector, and the third is how do you deliver it into the eye. So for example, I want to show here, I have finished the DM removal, but I see there are two small tags. Being overconfident, I really overlook it, and as you see that I'm trying to remove it perpendicularly, you see that the tear extending it. This is actually a very small tag. If I could have removed there, this tissue wouldn't have torn into the center. So you could prepare a very beautiful tissue, but when you punch, you have to be very careful or you will end up with these type of tags at the end. The second part of my talk is actually how do you transfer it into the injector. A very lot of type of injectors, the initial ICL cartridge, and this what prototype I use. Whatever injector you use, you have to have certain technique to take it inside the injector. And the third one is delivering it into the anterior chamber. If you do it very fast, it can get caught into the tunnel. Or if you do very fast, slow, you will be ending up finishing all your saline in your injector and you are caught up in this portion. So I'll be talking how to rectify each and every step. Before that, I don't want to go into a debate here. Just want to make two points here because I have no financial interest in any of these injectors. You want a plastic, you're a glass, there's a huge debate. You decide what you want to do, whichever is comfortable, you can do it. And also the size of the injector, whether it's a small, large, whether you want to keep the exact two scroll, double scroll, whatever you want to keep, you want to plan to inject right into the correct position. So 50% of times you can get a right one, 50% you don't get. Nobody is an expert in exactly putting it in, but you have to make your way in however you proceed doing DMAC as you become experienced. There are a lot of injectors. You can choose whichever is comfortable for you. The only thing is there are two techniques. I think 90-95% of surgeons, they use a direct method, and pull-through is another, just for postgraduates to know that there is a pull-in through also, like a DSAC, but most of us use only a direct method. So a few things what I've learned over the years, those three steps I will explain to you. So after doing a very good tissue removal, the periphery of the DM is usually removed. And as you remove the DM, you have to keep a look at the periphery. There are no tags or any irregular cut. It comes out very well, no problem. And I usually stain it at that position. Then what happens in some cases is that your trephine may not be good, your trephine edge may not cut properly, or you wouldn't have removed completely. So you look here, as I remove, there is a tag or there is maybe an irregular cut. So here what I do is I hold the tissue, and just like a rexus, you have to do it. You should not pull perpendicularly or tangentially up, you will end up tearing it. So here again, I've done a punch. The unstained portion is, I have not removed the 100% of the DM, because usually we remove only 90%, but sometimes it can come into your punch portion. So the other side also I'm trying to remove, it is not coming. So I have a very big area of unstained portion. Take time, put some stain, see how much you're stained. Now you're very clearly able to see that this portion is not very clearly removed. So go again there, do a, as I told you, a circular like a rexus portion, it usually beautifully comes. So here, it's a very minor thing, but if you can concentrate on this you will not lose the tissue at that juncture. The second part which I was telling is like, this is the portion where you will lose your maximum amount of endothelial cells while you transfer, because we have showed very good videos where very beautifully you can take into the injury, but this happens. Even a very well-trained DMAC surgeon, we can find it sometimes difficult to get it inside. So injector, what I've been, me and Dr. JK, we have been using it for more than 400 to 500 cases. An ordinary 1cc syringe with a IV set, and there's any normal C cartridge what we prepare every time and we use it. And this is a BSS, we put it into a normal IOL tub and then fill the injector with BSS. And then what we do is we remove the DM and we put it into this injector so that we have a space to move around. And most of the times it scrolls in very well, you can beautifully take it in. Sometimes elderly tissue when you start in may not scroll in, may look large. But what I want to show you here is, see that the endothelium is outside. I put an L mark. So our aim is to inject it just like that inside so that we can unfold it. This L, you want it in the same position. So here I'm trying to rotate it, see that the L is in the right position. So that when I inject it in, I will unfold it the same way. So here you can see that the tissue is reversed, meaning that you see that the L is reversed. So I'm trying to suck it. It's actually a broader portion. Actually, we should suck it towards a narrower portion. I'm trying to suck the broader portion. It's not coming in. Again, I'm trying to take it in through the narrower portion, but this side becomes broader. You see, I flip it. Once I flip it, I'm able to see that my mark is okay, and this is how I want to inject, and it comes in very well. And here again, I repeat, this is what I do. I just see the mark, it's okay. So this is how I want it once I inject it into the eye. So I try to take it into the injector. And again, reinforcing a broader area, don't go, you rotate it, take the thinner, the area which is narrower. And as you suck, you have to give maximum force for it to come in. And once it comes in, you have to slow down your suction and slowly it comes in. We hear the other one, which sometimes when you stain it and when you use your non-tooth brush, it can get caught. Just leave it into the saline for some time. It usually gets released. Here, what happens is, what I learned is, I tried to suck it as it is like this so that I thought it will be narrow, but we should never do it, because if it is stuck like this outside, once it goes inside the eye, it is difficult to suck it. And so actually, if there is any portion stuck, release it however way you want it. See that my L portion is, L is okay. So now I take it in. So here, what you have to understand is that you can take it in whichever position, but this is how I usually see that the L, I wanted to go inside smoothly and so that I'm able to open it. So this happens 50% of times, 50% you cannot go in, because once you inject it, it can get scrawled, it can get in a different way, it can go in, but this is how I try to do it. So the third is delivering into the DM. Everybody wants it to be very beautiful, going in very smoothly and unfolding. And it, but it doesn't happen always. What happens here is, sometimes, as I showed you first, it can get caught into the tunnel. So at this stage, we really don't know what to do, because the saline is over in your syringe, or you don't know what to do. You have to take it out and then you have to push it in. And all these causes a lot of endothelial damage. So this is another thing which I should show you, a tight tunnel. And I'll be injecting fast. So you see that inject fast and tight tunnel, you'll have the DM coming out and the cells can get damaged. So what I would suggest is, see, I'm going inside and injecting it. So it goes into the ant chamber. Again, I'm stuck up into this half portion. Since we are all phaco surgeons, we are ambidextrous. Take your left, with your left hand, take the saline. And as you inject, you see that the tissue goes in your sideboard. And then you take out and see what is the problem. And most of the times, the speculum, you have to adjust the speculum, because the speculum is the main culprit, maybe very tight. So you have to loosen it, form the anterior chamber, and then you see that it beautifully goes. So such a small correction, that because you have to make the anterior chamber soft when you inject. The second is your tunnel. Don't fight over your tunnel. If your tunnel is small, please make it a little bit large. Do not fight over the tunnel, because you will have problem when you inject. I'm doing that, and again, I'm releasing the speculum. Make the eye as much soft as possible so that you don't get any back flesh fluid into your syringe. So once I enlarge, it goes in very beautifully. Here again, another eye syndrome where there is no space. As I go in, I see that the iris gets plugged in. Pardon?
you have to conclude.
Yeah, I'm going to conclude. Yeah. So once it goes in, you can put the saline in and you can inject it into the. To summarize what I have talked, take the DM very carefully. If there are any tags, remove it in a circular portion. So this is a very key point. The second point, what I want to tell is when you take it, I usually take it in the normal L shape which I want it to unfold. And third, make a very smooth injection. And you can see that the L mark is there. And then always suture it, make a suture before you try to manipulate. You see that one suture is very, very mandatory before you do it. And then just little bit tapping saline and that's it. Actually, it's an unedited picture and then that's it. So, okay, thank you. And choose what is comfortable, repeatable and successful in your hands. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Siddharth. Yes. How you manage in a case of aphakia or large PI with vitrectomized eyes? When you inject, the eye is so soft, the graft goes into the vitreous. Has it happened any time to you or how do you manage?
It happens. Most of the times, aphakic cases, I try to do an iris claw. Other than that, if it is going to be aphakic, most of the times, iris claw is the only solution. But if, as you say, if there is a very large PI, then I would like to do a DSAC in all these cases and rather than to do a DMAC because once it goes inside the vitreous, it becomes difficult and also post-operatively, air management becomes a difficult portion. So most of the times when there's a large PI or it's aphakic, you're not able to do an iris claw, most probably go for a DSAC. I would prefer a DSAC.
What you do goes into the vitreous. You leave it or you ask the vitreous surgeon to take it out like a IOL?
So I had one case previously, then we had to take it out and discard it and I was not able to remove it. I don't like to fish it. Maybe I'll ask the surgeon to remove it out and then put a fresh piece or you have to leave it just like that. You cannot too much manipulate once it goes into the vitreous.
Thank you.